the double column cash book, the double column cash book, we say the cash book with two columns. In the problem number 4, we will be solving the problem number 4, in which you are instructed to prepare, record the following transactions in two column cash book. Now, which are the two columns, he did not say. So, only after reading the problem, you can analyze which two columns you have to prepare. Now, if you see here, if you read the problems, I have taken it as cash and bank column. But if you read the whole problem, you will find there is not many transactions related to bank. As a result, here we have to prepare the cash book with cash and discount columns. So I have one column for cash. On the debit side, we will have discount allowed column. On debit side, we have discount allowed column. On the credit side, we have discount received column. Now, this discount allowed and discount received, you should remember, is not received or given in cash. It is a nominal account. It indicates the amount which you lost, which you are not going to get because it is a loss for you, or you can treat it as an expense, it's nominal. And when you are getting a concession, that means you are not going to pay some amount. Okay, as a result, you are getting benefited with gain. So therefore, we credit discount received and we debit discount allowed based on the rule of nominal account. Otherwise, they don't represent amounts received or amounts paid. So, coming to the problem, it is for the month of January 2014, and first it is stated on 1st Jan balance of cash 5500. So, the year 2014 and the month January. So, 1st Jan we will be writing two balance brought down, the amount being 5500. Remember, you will not have any opening balance or closing balance for discount allowed and discount received, because periodically at the end of the month, this discount allowed and this discount received will be total, and you will post the total into discount allowed account and discount received column total to the credit of discount received account. Now, coming to the next transaction, it is on 2nd. The transaction is paid to Nagarjuna, discount received. It's a payment. So, how much you are paying? You are paying 1250. So, enter 1250. Now, from the same person, you are getting a discount of 250. So, you are entering 250 and the person is Nagarjuna. So, enter his name in the particulars column, by Nagarjuna. The date is 2nd Jan. Now, if you carefully look here, if you see, actually you have to pay 1500 to Nagarjuna. Since you are paying him only 1250 and he is giving you a concession of 250. So, this being gain, applying the rule of nominal account, we are entering the gain 250 on the credit side. And since the payment is 1250, we are recording in cash column, because cash has to be credited when it goes out. Now, the next transaction is on 4th. It is cash sales. Cash sales, you are getting cash and the amount is 1000. So, when you get the amount, enter it on the debit side. So, entering 1000 in the debit side, two constant, reason sales, and this thing is 4th Jan. Then, let us see the next transaction of 6th, that is stated as cash purchases. Cash purchases means purchase of goods for cash. So, purchase of goods for cash, we have 900. So, cash is going out. So, therefore, go to the Credit side, enter 900 in cash column. Buy constant. What is the reason for payment of 900? Purchases. So write purchases. The date being 6th Jan. Now, the next transaction is on 10th, which states that received cash from Raju 850, discount allowed 150. Received cash from Raju 850, discount allowed 150. So it is receipt of cash, so therefore record it on the debit side. So enter 850 cash which you are receiving from him in cash column, and 150 is discount allowed, meaning you are losing this 150, you are not going to get, so it's a loss. So based on the rule of nominal account, we are debiting this 150 as discount allowed. Our transaction is with whom? Raju. So therefore record his name in the particulars column. The transaction is on 10th. Next, we have transaction on 16th. Paid cash to Mahesh rupees 650, discount received 150. This transaction has to be treated just like the transaction on 2nd Jan. So as a result, we are entering 650 in amount column, 150 in discount received column, and the name of Mahesh in particulars column. So by Mahesh, and the transaction is on 16th. So that's how you enter this transaction. Now on 18th, it is paid advertisement expenses 600. So cash is going out, so therefore record 600 in the credit column on the credit side, and you will write by advertisement, by advertisement, the amount and the date being 18th, the date being 18th. Then coming next on 20th, you have received cash from Praveen, 800, discount allowed 200. So on 20th, you received 800 from Praveen. So enter 800 on the debit side in the amount column, and you gave a discount of 200, so enter 200 in discount allowed column, and enter the name of Praveen in particulars column. So to Praveen, and the date is 20th, so enter the date. Next transaction is on 24th. It is paid for repairs, cash is going out, therefore we have to enter the amount on the credit side, 400. Reason is repairs, so by constant and repairs, and the date is 20th. Next, again it's a payment, sorry, on 27th it is sold newspapers, sold old newspapers 200. We sell usually the old newspapers as scrap. When we sell, we get some cash, so therefore cash is coming in, so enter the amount on the debit side in the amount column. The reason is two old newspaper sales, the date being 27th. Now, the next transaction, received cash from Ram, rupees 325, discount allowed 75. So again, it's a receipt, we record it on the receipt side. So enter the amount in the amount column, 325. We are not going to get 75, so it's a loss, so discount allowed is a loss, we are debiting it. And from whom we are receiving this money? From Ram. So therefore record Ram's name and the date being 29th. The last transaction is paid salaries. The last transaction is paid salaries 750. Cash is going out, so therefore record it on the payment side, 750. The reason is salaries, so state it in the particulars, and the date is 30th. Now, that's all are the transactions for this month. First, let us see how to close the discount columns. You will not balance discount columns. They have to be simply totaled and left. So here we have discount allowed, that is equal to 425. So discount allowed is 425. Then Let us see how much is discount received. That is 400. So that's all. You need not do the balancing. Now let us see what are the totals on debit side and credit side.